Okay, in today's training, we're going to talk all about how to get you paid, how to set up those invoices, and get everything set up so that when your clients are ready to roll on in, you are ready too. So we are going back to the studio portion. You're going to scroll all the way down to this invoice setup. That's where you want to start first. And I want to talk about the difference between the invoice setup and the invoice templates. So the invoice setup is where you're going to choose your payment processors. You're going to go through the settings, add any integrations that IrisWorks currently offers, and then you are going to start setting up your products, okay? This, again, could be services types of sessions. This could be your retainers. This could be your upsells, all the things. And I will go walk through the different options for you. So the very first thing that you want to do is you want to make sure that you are set up for payment processors. Now, I get this question a lot. Is there a direct deposit option in IrisWorks? The answer is no, because IrisWorks does not have their own, they're not their own payment processor. So they are still connecting with third-party apps that you already should be signed up for anyway. So your options with IrisWorks is PayPal, Square, and Stripe. Now, their preferred partner is Square. So if you already have Square, this should be very easy for you. You're just going to connect it and it will automatically connect to where you are able to get paid. Okay. I personally do not have Square. I'll be the first to admit that. I had Square a long time ago for a boutique, but I do not use Square for my photography business, but I do have both PayPal Business and a Stripe account. So if you have those, then you are able to connect those and that's how you are going to get paid. IrisWorks does not have any additional payment processing fees outside of your third-party app. So IrisWorks does not make money off of you making money, okay? Where they get their profit is from your annual subscription or your monthly subscription or whatever that looks like. There's no additional processing fees on top of what these third-party apps already have in their policies. And so you can read through those. Everybody's very close, very neck and neck of being the same. Now, there is one payment processor I know. I have this discussion all the time, and that is Venmo. Venmo recently came out with an option to have a business profile. This is not available to everyone. It rolled out in a beta, and I happen to be one of the people that got selected for it. However, I can still allow my clients to pay me. I just have to come into IrisWorks and mark it manually and write a little note to myself that they paid via Venmo and not through one of these payment processors. So something to keep in mind, right now, there are no other third-party payment processors. And as of right now, there are not plans to be any more at this time. So you definitely need to commit to one of these three payment processors in order to get paid and through IrisWorks to have them connect to each other. Okay. Hope you liked my fun little hand movement there. Okay. The next thing, once you've got your accounts connected and set up, you're going to hop down to settings. This is just simply letting IrisWorks know what currency you're using. Are you charging sales tax? Do you want tips on invoices? Now, the only payment processor where this is going to be an option is Square. So just keep that in mind. And then do you want them to send automatic payment reminders? Now, I love this feature. It says that Iris will automatically send reminders for invoices with payment schedules. Those reminders will be sent 5 days before the installment is due and on installment due dates. I love this if someone has a payment plan with you, or if you are in the education side of photography, maybe you offer mentorships, whatever that looks like for you, I would go ahead and leave this the check mark on. It's always nice to know that the app you're using, the management system you're using, is sending automatic reminders to people about payments so that you don't have to have those conversations yourself. So once you're done, you can also include a customized email message when your invoices go out. You would just type that in this box and then you would click save. moving on down to the next thing. This is integration. So if you have Fundy or QuickBooks Online, you can connect those. Those help with the bookkeeping aspect of your business. And so that's all that is. If you don't use either one of those, you just leave this section alone. And then you're going to hop down to invoice products. Okay, so some things that you're going to want to see here is you're definitely going to want to have a session retainer. And so you're going to name this what you want it called, and then you can describe it. So for me, I would do non-refundable session retainer. You're going to lock in a price, let's just say $100 to keep it simple. And then if you charge taxes, and I'm not getting into this, you will not find a video where I'm explaining this. You need to know how to operate your business. And if you're not sure, then you need to reach out to your accountant, CPA, bookkeeper, somebody, and try to get that information. But you're going to mark taxable if you are charging taxes with your sessions, or you're going to leave it alone and click the check mark. That's automatically going to save it. Okay. So you should have a session retainer. I also have I would recommend putting in your services. So let's say family session, your description is a 1 hour family session. If you want to, you can go in here and just start saying what comes with it. Let's say 25 images and print release if you get one. Okay, so just whatever you want to put in the description, then you can hop over here and you can type in whatever price you have. And again, click the check mark to automatically save. Okay, guys, I'm literally riffing off numbers. Let's not try to get into the details of all of that. Definitely no arguments in the comments. I'm literally throwing out numbers to you guys. Okay. The next thing that you can have is, let's say that you do a gallery upsell. So if you are, you've promised somebody that they get 10 or 15 images, you end up getting 30 or 40 and you want to try to upsell that. Let's just say you have a gallery upsell. So you could put additional images or whatever you want to in the description. Let's just say additional images for download. And then let's say that is a $250 upsell. Boom, there you go. So we've got retainers, session types, upsells. And then if you sell any type of products, maybe you have a collection. So let's say it's collection one. This includes some prints, a canvas of some sort, an album, etc. Okay, whatever you're going to put in there. And let's say you sold a $1,200 package. There you go. Okay, so these, again, these are simply for you to list out everything that you're going to sell, any a la carte items, anything extra, anything at all. You're going to go put your list of things right here first before you go into invoice templates, okay? So that's where we're headed next, is invoice templates. So inside of invoice templates, this is where you're setting up. What does it actually look like? Do you need templates for certain things, okay? So we're gonna do a new template. We're gonna call this session retainer. They have 1 day to pay it. And then in your little memo, you could say this invoice is for the non-refundable session retainer to secure, your date on my calendar. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go over here to this purple add plus button. And that's when you're gonna add in the actual session retainer, click the check mark, and it'll add it in there. So this is what it's going to look like when you send this to somebody. So again, it's a session retainer. They have 24 hours to pay it. This reminds them what this is for, okay? So what I love about these memos inside of your invoices is that everything inside your contract, these are things that you're pulling sentences out of your contract so that they have seen it multiple times. How many of you have signed a contract and not read it word for word? I think we're all guilty, okay? So this is so that you're making sure they understand that they are paying a non-refundable retainer to get on your calendar. That's very, very important, because there's no question of, if I don't show up Or if I need to cancel, if I need to reschedule, can I have my money back? Right there, it's just a nice reminder for us so we don't get into those tangled situations. So once everything's exactly how you want it, you can click save. And there you go, you got a session retainer. And then you're just gonna work your way through each thing. Now, there is a cool thing, you are able to add a payment plan. So really quickly, I'm gonna do that collection one. Really quickly, days until due, I'm going to say if someone, let's just say 3 days, okay? And then again, this invoice covers the purchase of collection one, and then whatever else you want to say, just something. And then we're going to add in that actual collection one option. And let's say that you do offer your people to make a payment plan. So it's not necessarily that they get everything up front without paying. It's just once they make that final payment, then you'll go ahead and put the order in. So what you can do down here is you can add a payment schedule. So let's say someone needs, they're gonna do a retainer in multiple payments, okay? So we're gonna choose a frequency. Let's say they say every 2 weeks they wanna make a payment. So they have to put $100 down, okay? And then number of additional payments, let's say they wanna pay this off in 6 weeks. Boom, do y'all see how that automatically came up? So down here, they are gonna have 6 weeks to pay off this order, all right? And I know this is extreme, I'm just showing you. So when they get their invoice, they have to pay $100 in order to start the payment plan. And then every 2 weeks, they're paying this amount until it's paid off. And then we're clicking finish, all right? So that's what they would get. And it's automatically going to, and see, it'll tell you down here, this doesn't add up to the total amount due for this invoice. I'm literally just giving you an example. Okay, I just wanna show you how it works. I don't really care about the numbers at this point. So what will happen is as soon as you issue this invoice off to somebody, then it will automatically send them reminders and send them that payment every 2 weeks. So you're hands off, you don't have to worry about it. And then you can check on it at least once a month to make sure that person is still paying and not skipping and all that. But that's a really cool option for a payment schedule if you need to offer those in your business. So that is it for invoicing, for getting paid, for setting things up. If something does not make sense, or if you have a situation that is completely personal to you, maybe it's just a situation a lot of photographers don't have, feel free to drop those in the comments and I'll circle back and get your question answered. And if I can't answer it, I know IrisWorks and their community can answer it. So please don't hesitate to get the help if you're needing some help. And I hope you found this video helpful and I'll see you in the next one.